We shall be following that story and we shall be giving you details as it unfolds. Let's now head over to Parliament, where the Speaker of the House has directed the Rules Committee to investigate claims that the race for speakership and the deputy has been monetized. This follows a matter of national importance raised by Kabula County Member of Parliament, James Kakoza, who questioned why the House was subjected to derogatory exchanges between camps of Rebecca Kadaga and those of Jacob Olanya.
The code of conduct, the code of conduct of the current, even some elect members who are not sworn in, the elect members who are not sworn in, they are using a bad language because of the institution. We cannot afford to injure the institution we believe in because of we have our personal interest. All of us, we can go, but we leave the institution when it's not damaged.
Kakoza's submission was amplified by fellow legislators Joseph Seungu, Maurice Chibalia, Sarah Opendi, Asuman Basalirwa, among others. They accused the government chief whip, Ruth Nankabirwa, of dragging issues of the Central Executive Committee via different WhatsApp groups.
The Honourable was saying, we are supporting, we have our WhatsApp groups. When I'm put in a group where I'm not supporting, I switch off myself, I exit. So I think this matter, Madam Speaker, is key, and we must give it a lot of attention. But I cannot fear mentioning, because some of you are fearing to mention, I have had the chief whip, when we are going for the NRM primaries, she said that she has been suffering from Kadaga throughout, the way she has suffered in the parliament. It is very known. She said it on the steps, and the cameras are available.
Right, Honourable Speaker, on most of the forums, the chief whip has been seen writing that SEC has decided, that SEC, that State House is saying, and it has said, that for us who have made a point, and for us who have decided, on record, right honourable speaker, here, the chief whip here.
Much right honourable speaker. Right honourable speaker, what has been happening in the media is something that, allow me to use the word disgusting and completely unacceptable. I have been in this parliament, Madam Speaker, since 2011, and what is happening now is completely unprecedented. Madam Speaker, we have been electing speakers and the deputy speaker without monetizing this process. But when you look at what is going on now, you wonder whether this is going to be a transaction of parliament. Where are we heading to, Madam Speaker? Why should people use money to become speakers and deputy speakers of this parliament?
So, right honourable speaker, may I have a question that I'm posing to you. Is it true that actually SEC does not want you when we are supporting you? Is it true, right honourable speaker? Whether SEC wants who or who, the decision on who becomes the Speaker of this House will come from this House. It will not come from Changwanzi, it will not come from State House. And right honourable speaker, I want to put you on notice, regardless of the decision of SEC, you must be on the ballot paper here. It should be us to decide. And I hear there are machinations elsewhere. Where do you leave us who don't sit in SEC, who don't belong to your caucus, and yet we think you can serve this country?
With members of parliament freely declaring their adoration for Speaker Rebecca Kadaga, Nankabirwa took to the floor to defend herself, but was ruled out of order for imposing check issues on the House.
What I posted was a reminder of the SEC decision of 2016, where SEC persuaded Honourable Olanya to step down for right Honourable Rebecca Kadaga.
Honourable, do you want us now to bring the SEC members to confirm or deny what you are saying? Please,
Madam.
Please.
We can do that. This is a reminder I made. It will remain on record. There were negotiations that time. There will be negotiations even this time.
Order, Madam Speaker, order.
We are in a multi-party election.
Order.
The party in office.
Kadaga stuck to her guns and told the House that campaigns for speakership have been vulgarized. This has been done through the printing of t-shirts, booklets, pens, among others, she said.
The printing of tables, tablets, the printing of books, the printing of pens.
Procedure, Madam Speaker.
Please, Honorable Sam, would you hold on? Please, hold on. That is not the way the Speaker's campaign is conducted. Those who have been here know that we never print t-shirts, we don't print posters, we don't print pens. All this is not done in the Speaker's campaign. That's why I'm saying it has been vulgarized.
Although Kadaga, a contestant in the speakership race, was presiding over today's sitting, Kira Municipality Member of Parliament Ibrahim Semuju Nganda, one of the contestants, saw this as a conflict of interest, since the same speaker will be contesting for the position.
Because our rules are very clear on matters of conflict of interest. Madam Speaker, I have heard people say I am Tim Kadaga, which disqualifies you from presiding over any debate on matters to do with the election of the speaker. Because doing so means that you are using the platform of Parliament to disadvantage some of us who have also declared their intentions.
Speaker Rebecca Kadaga concluded the matter by referring it to the Committee of Rules for Investigation. Kadaga said Ruth Nankabirwa does not speak for CHEC and the decisions of CHEC do not bind Parliament in any way, so she should stop bringing issues of CHEC in the House.
Out of order. Yes, honourable members. Honourable Nankabirwa does not speak for the Central Executive Committee. No, she's not the spokesperson of the Central Executive Committee. I don't think the Central Executive Committee has a right to bind a future parliament before even they're elected. That's undemocratic, totally undemocratic. Stop talking about SEC here. We are talking about issues of the House.
This story was compiled by Rachel Nakasi and Obedi Lutale for the news in Kampala.